support them.
They are called Team Pittsburgh, led by an offense that has these three 100-point scorers. And a 21-year-old who's almost there, and a money goaltender who just won't lose, and the best player in the world. Team Pittsburgh goes up against the New York Islanders, a severe underdog in this series, led by Ray Ferraro, who's leading all playoff scorers and goals. But they will not have their number one scorer, Pierre Turgeon. For Al Arbor, the joy of victory was suddenly saddened. Today, the Islanders take to the ice in Pittsburgh to try and defeat the two-time Stanley Cup champion. And hello, everybody. This is Gary Thorne, and welcome to ABC's continuing coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Round two, game one. The New York Islanders
have been able to keep the puck away from Barrasso, so even the wide shots, they hope to end up creating some kind of adventure for them.
Well, they had one right there. Malakoff with a cannon scores! Can this guy shoot? Malakoff, the rocket. Barrasso didn't react until the puck was coming out of the net.
What a shot. Gary, Malakoff, even in the National Hockey League, didn't really discover how dangerous his shot was until a couple of months into the season. This is one of the rookies I was talking about on the blue line. He's 24 years old, 6'2", 207 pounds, and can he rip it? Blew it by Tom Barrasso last year in Russia. In his club team in the Elite League, Gary played 40 games, he got one goal. This year he got 14 goals in the National Hockey League.
Tocket, one man advantage, 5-on-4 now. Mullen back for Murphy, lost it just out of the box. Ray Ferraro, breakaways on side. Scores! Ray Ferraro just out of the penalty box has given the Islanders a 2-1 lead on a shorthanded goal.
And the wrong guy to end up giving a breakaway to. Ray Ferraro, the hottest New York Islander in the playoffs, and Gary, I gotta tell you, he put a major league move on Tom Barrasso, and now the Penguins are arguing, perhaps they're arguing that it was a two-line pass, because the puck can't cross two lines and get to a player who was there waiting for it. If the player follows the puck over the second line, that's fine, but here it is, jumping over Larry Murphy's stick. Well, that certainly is a two-line pass.
I think they are questioning whether he got back on side after he came out.
Watch this move, though. He showed shot. That throws Tom Barrasso. Move with the hand that let Tom Barrasso think he was going to shoot. Absolutely froze Barrasso. Larry Murphy was trying to gamble to get a shot away. He had to know Ferraro was coming out. Ferraro knows he's got time. Look at him, he's cradling the puck, gets it flat first. Now watch what he does. Ooh, I'm going to shoot. No way. Tom Barrasso went for the first move, and Ferraro made a terrific deep to the back end. Give credit.
His ninth goal of the playoffs, leading five power play goals. New York Islanders were 16th in killing off penalties during the regular season. Here's a chance. New York Islanders shorthanded, dumped in front, shot, Barrasso scores! The New York Islanders, Benoit Hogue, can you believe, right off the face-off, a 3-1 lead, their second shorthanded goal of the day.
Well, you called it, and I'll tell you what, Benoit Hogue's knuckle looked pretty good on that one. I mean, it's Benoit Hogue, look at him standing all alone in front. And you know the tendency when you're on the power play, well, Barrasso didn't have a chance. The tendency on the power play is to forget about the coverage. I mean, it's so easy to last in or only don't have a chance. It's in our end. We've got five guys here. It's going to be no problem. If you don't have a regular strength mentality, at least on the faceoff, things like that happen.
Surprise, surprise, surprise. Right here. Separated shoulder. Hunter, of course, has been indefinitely suspended. The league has not yet decided what they're going to do about Hunter. Turgeon's just waiting to play, and Al Morganti is with him. Al?
Pierre, first of all, how is the shoulder? How does it feel? I know you had therapy this morning. Is it coming along okay?
Yeah, I feel pretty good right now, but still, a little bit sore, and I can't really do some quick movement. I gotta go really slow, and last few days I've been doing therapy, and hopefully it's gonna be better with that in the next week or so, and we'll see from there.
Originally we thought 6 weeks, and in the playoffs a lot of times the guys get healthier quicker than they should, I guess you could say. Is there any chance you come back in this series, winning the first game if it goes long enough?
Well, that'll be tough, but you never know. You know, we're working hard right now to get some, movement on the shoulder, and like I said, we'll see. We're taking day by day, and see from there. Right now, we can't really tell when it's going to get back.
Okay, you came in today from New York to be around the club. Can you still be a factor with the team, a leader in the locker room, in spite of the injury?
Oh, yeah, I mean, I just, I want to try to follow the team, and to be here, I think, I went to the dressing room before and, give, talk with the guys, and the guys, want to do well without me in the lineup, and I think they will. And like I said, I want to be around the guys, and like you said, I want to be a factor to...